We're going to start our problem with a rectangle. Then we're going to use two semicircles. The diameter of the first semicircle is going to be equal to the right height of our rectangle, and the area of this semicircle will be equal to 1. Then on the upper side of our rectangle, from the upper right corner, we're going to construct another identical semicircle, as you can see on the sketch. Now the remaining segment of the upper side of our rectangle will be the diameter of new semicircle, and the bottom side of our rectangle will be diameter of another final semicircle, which is also going to touch the smaller semicircle, as you can see on the sketch. The question is, can you find the combined area of those two inscribed semicircles? I would like to thank my subscriber Nicole, who suggested me this wonderful problem. And of course, you guys can pause the video right now, try it out for yourself, and then come back and check the solution. Alright, so let's solve this one. So first, I would like to apologize in advance, because I'm not going to label all the vertices in this sketch, because I think that we can solve this problem quite easily without it. So first, I'm just going to label both radii of our two outer semicircles with the areas of 1, and then we can say that the area of one semicircle is equal to the 1/2 of pi r squared. Of course, we know that the area of semicircle equals to 1, so we can simplify this equation by multiplying with 2, and finally we will get that r squared is equal to 2 over pi. And we're going to leave this as it is. Now, let's go ahead and label the radius of our inner big semicircle as A and smallest semicircle as B. Let's expand those radius a little bit. First, let's take a look at the green radius on the right, and we can expand this radius horizontally and vertically like this, and in this way we will get the height of our rectangle. Next, we can do the same for the outer semicircle on the top. And the remaining segment on the top will be equal to the radius of small circle, which equals to b. Now, on the bottom, we know that the radius of big semicircle equals to a, which means that the right part is also equal to a. Now, let's clear our image a little bit, and if we do this, you can notice that the sum of both red and green radii on the top is equal to the sum of the diameter of our circle on the bottom, since those two lengths are both sides of our rectangle. So, we can say that 2b plus 2r equals 2a. Now we can simplify everything with 2, and we will get that b plus r equals to a, and we can rewrite this to get that r equals to a minus b. Now we're going to save those two values for later, because they're going to be super important. Now let's continue on by first rotating the both radii of big and the small circle to the point of tangency. If we do this, those two radii will form a straight line. We know this by using the circular theorem, which states that if two circles touch each other, externally or internally, then their point of contact lies on a straight line joining their centers. And as you can see, this is exactly our case on the sketch on the left. Now let's take a look at the center of our small inscribed circle, and let's pull vertical line from this center downwards to the bottom side. Now, if we slide the upper radius of this semicircle, we can see that the remaining segment of the bottom blue radius will be actually equal to the difference between those two radii, so it equals to a minus b. Furthermore, we can slide the height of our rectangle located on the right side to this line. And if we do this, we will get this really nice right-angled triangle. Now, we can use the Pythagorean theorem for this triangle. We can say that hypotenuse of a plus b squared must be equal to the vertical leg 2r squared plus the horizontal leg of a minus b squared. Now we can expand this by putting everything to the square and using the square root binomial formula, and we will get the following. Here we can simplify by canceling a square and b square on both sides of the equation, and if we rewrite this, we will get that 4ab equals to 4r squared. Of course, we can simplify everything with 4, and we will get that a times b actually equals to r squared. And now let's save this value and let's again use our same Pythagorean theorem. And now we're going to use it in a little bit of a different way. We're going to substitute the value of a minus b for value of r, which we got earlier. And if we do this, we will get the Pythagorean theorem, which looks something like this. Now we can expand the left side by using the square of binomial again, and we're going to square the right side, and we will get the following. Now let's substitute the value of a times b on the left side of the equation with r squared, which we got earlier. And if we do this, we will get completely new equation, which looks something like this. Now, if we put all the terms with r squared on the right side of the equation and calculate, we will get that a squared plus b squared is equal to 3r squared. But now, furthermore, we can substitute the value of r squared with 2 over pi. This is the first value that we got. And if we insert this value, we will get the following, which means that a squared plus b squared must have the value of 6 over pi. Now, remember, we're looking for the combined area of those two inscribed semicircles. So we can find this area by just adding the area of both semicircles. So this means that this red area equals to pi a squared over 2 for big semicircle and pi b squared over 2 for small semicircle. Now we can notice that pi over 2 is a common factor for those two terms, so we can isolate it in front of the brackets and get the following. Finally, we will substitute the value of a squared plus b squared for 6 over pi, which we got earlier, and we will get the following. Here we can cancel both values of pi, and we can simplify 6 and 2, and we will finally get that the area of those two circles combined is equal to 3 squared units, and this is our awesome solution. Well, to be honest with you, I love how this solution turned out to be, and I hope that you guys love it too. If you did, please do not hesitate to leave a like or subscribe to the channel for more content like this. Of course, if you found another way to solve this problem, please write it down in the comment section as you always do. And until next time, as always, see you guys and take care.